Hello everybody and welcome back to The Average. If you're new here, my name's Steph, I'm the average artist and I make art. I don't know what
else to introduce myself.
So we're doing things a little bit differently today because obviously you can see there's already art created here, but we're going to be finishing this piece that has taken me a long time. I've been posting reels and things like that to Instagram, shorts, everything about these characters. So who are they? They are all movie characters, and if you don't know that, then I guess like maybe this video isn't for you. But I think it would be very, very rare if somebody out there didn't know at least one of these people, maybe even two or three, but they're very like famous iconic movie character moments, I would say, movie dresses. Like them, and we're gonna finish these four off because they take a long time, each one, surprisingly. Even though they're little, they take a long time. So, next up, we have the girl from the labyrinth. What's her name? I am actually really bad with names, so when it comes to like even remembering names in movies and stuff, I'm like, even though I love the movie and everything, I don't remember. But yeah, her name is Sarah, because I can see that on the Pinterest that I've made. I made a massive Pinterest board with all the characters. Characters, yeah? No, they are characters, yes. Characters, I was correct. And the dresses, I don't know if you can hear my kitten crying in the background. She wants to come out of that room, she's not going to be allowed. Be quiet, Zelda. I don't even remember what I was saying. But yeah, these take forever to draw, because they're kind of intricate and small. But this one, I feel as well, is gonna be difficult because she has like this kind of shimmeriness to her dress. It's like a green shimmer, even though it's white-ish. It's like off-white. So I think we're gonna do like a pinky. And I really have to study these like swatches that I made because the colors on the tops of these are so different. So if you get these, make sure you fill out like this swatch card, because even the colors on that don't even reflect how they really are. So bear that in mind. I'm like having this here, it's my little Bible. So I'm just gonna maybe, oh, that's really dark. You know what? I said check the thing and I didn't check it myself. That was brilliant. Brilliant work. I've also organized all these pens into these colors, but because I've been using them, I haven't like sorted them out properly again, because you know, that would make too much sense, wouldn't it? That would be too much like, I feel like that's too dark as well. So I'm gonna get my little Zero blender, which I'm a little bit like, how do we use these? A little bit. I know it blends the colors together, but I sometimes use it when I make a mistake to pick up the color, because it does a little bit. It obviously blends the colors together. I know what it does, but I don't really use it very much. My voice is croaky. Maybe if I use like a really light color, like R1 all over, and then do the shadows rather than try to, because it's not really, it's not really this color either. It's like a lot of different shades. I don't know if this dress is like particularly coming out very nice. I will zoom in for you because you probably can't even see very well what I'm doing. Basically a gray blob at the moment is what you can see. She has like, okay, so she has like really dark brown hair, but I don't want to do like black hair because I think it's more brown. I mean, this is very close to black. She has like all this trash in her hair as well, because you know that Goblin King is loading her up with trash. I just realized I could probably use pencils to indicate a little bit more what the dress is doing. Okay, so she has like these little gray pumps on as well, which are not very pretty, but hey. I need to order more of these Faber-Castell black pencils because I really use them. It's the black pencil I've chosen that works the best for me, for my drawings and stuff. What do you want? Esther's like, I want to lie exactly where you're drawing. My parents' dog chewed up one of them, and I tried to salvage it with, but like that's just pathetic, so I need to order a couple more. Because I do get through them, to be fair. It's not like I'm just ordering for excess. I think what I'll do is, yeah, I will color it with pencil a little bit more. I was using this Mono Zero Tombow razor, but I've run out of the refill. I need to order more, but it was really good because obviously that is just the right size to get into all the little tight spots. And I recently reviewed this rubber, which I thought was to get into tight spots, but then I'm like, how? I don't know, but it kind of works. Kind of like, it's not as precise as this one, but I need to order more refills. But yeah, let's move on to the next in show, which is this lady. And if you know it from the sketch, then you are a real one. I don't know what that means, a real one, but you're a real one. I've noticed as well, as I was like doing these drawings, that they got steadily bigger and bigger, but I can fix it on Photoshop. It's fine. So just ignore the fact that these three women down here are giants compared to everyone else. To be fair, they probably all do vary in height. Some of them are probably a lot shorter than others, but you know, for the symmetry of the poster, we're gonna try and keep it fairly even. Not just a giant woman. Problem with using so much pencil is that it's just left marks everywhere, so it's very hard to like clean the paper up. But it doesn't matter because Photoshop will help me again. Yes, Trufa, can I help you? Trufa is my parents' dog, and she's the reason that this pencil was chewed. So I think she's eyeing up her next victim. She's taking a piece of paper and she's running. Rude. What color for the green? So it's like an emerald green. So I'm guessing a mix of these two would work. So we could use this and then this for like the shadows. Okay, let's do it, guys. That's the plan, okay? And then it looks completely different on this paper. That's another thing to bear in mind, is that this paper is kind of off-white. So when you do kind of use the colors, they are slightly different. Like, not different enough to be bothered to do swatches again on this paper, but different enough. And the way that Keira, that's right, guys, it's Keira Knightley, if you haven't guessed the movie yet, or the role, is kind of like stomping around in this dress as well, which makes it really beautiful because it's like silk, I think. So the way it just flows is so stunning. Did we say stunning? Yes, we did. My lungs. Kind of doesn't look right, but maybe we can do some highlighting with this white pencil that I have, which is what I've been doing for other dresses, which I did here, but I think I want to rub out this line as well for her. Her skin is super pale, so we're gonna go with a super pale skin color. She has a really long neck as well because she's super tall, I guess. And her other arm is like hidden well behind her, which is every artist's dream. Because you don't have to draw the other arm. And she has brown hair, which is up in some sort of updo thing. This movie's so sad, right? I hated it. I hate it. Okay, we're on to the next one. And if you can guess this one, well done. I've never actually seen this movie. I think this is the only one I haven't seen the movie of, actually. Somebody suggested it because I asked on Instagram what people think I should draw for like movie dresses, because, you know, I want to do iconic stuff. And I think this one is very iconic because, you know, I recognize it, I know it, even though I've never seen the movie, so that must mean it's super iconic if you just know it from not even watching the film. But yeah, if you know who this is, or if you've seen the film, comment down below before the answer. No, you have 5 seconds to comment down below in order to win your chance of liking this video. I wanted to redraw her slightly because I think she was just like ginormous. Ginormous, that's not a word. It's cute though. No wonder everyone liked her. She's such an iconic. Can you stop shaking the table, Gigi? Please. This dress is gonna be so hard to color because it's got so much like shimmeriness. Also, these bows are not like this obviously bow in this, this obviously bow. They're not so clear in this image reference I'm using, but I'm making it a bit more clear so it's like, you can tell when you've done something wrong because if you look at the negative space. So I'm looking at like this little triangle area between her hands and her head, and it's so off in my drawing. Like, it's so much bigger, the space in the reference image. But we're just gonna have to go with it, guys. rub it out now. It's gone. I think I rubbed it out too much, but whatever. Okay, whatever. This is where this eraser comes in handy. It's very hard for me to say eraser and not the other word, but let's just do her skin first. She's quite bronzed in this. So BR1 maybe? I don't know. Is that bronzed? Not really. I can add a bit of colour to it if it looks too pale though, can't I? That's the beauty of doing art. Because why can't you just put your pens back where you found them? I don't know, self. Because you got a problem. Definite. There it is, I found you. Sucker. Don't need to organise my pens again, it's fine. I really want to try and get the light though, so I'm going to leave sections of this dress white. If it doesn't look right, we can always use the white. What is this? Jelly roll, you know. Classic jelly roll marker. Not a marker, what is this? What is this? It's a pen. It's a pen. What type of pen? I don't know, I can't remember. I'm taking this very seriously, by the way, in case you hadn't noticed. So I'd really appreciate if you appreciated me and saw that I'm drying. Going crazy, guys. I don't understand. Okay, so in between there's gonna be like some bits that are darker. But this will look hopefully better once I do the pencil. I need to do the arms as well. So they also have like the light shining on them. Just did a blob for a hand. I didn't look at my underdrawing at all. And then of course she's got really light blonde hair. Oh, but you don't really see her hair too much because she's covering it up. But obviously she's got loads of diamonds on. So we're gonna have to like definitely use this jelly roll pen that I do know the name of. I do know it. Can't think of it right now. Okay. Goes like this, goes round the side, and then crumples. It's like crumpled at the bottom. Kind of nearly there. It looks a little bit off, I think, but whatever. I love this video. It's like me just slowly going mad because I have to draw like people who are small. What the hell is that hand? What is that? Oh, I hope I can revive this. All right, everybody quiet, because I need to focus. Oh, that looks weird as well. Thumb is not that high up, you doof. My gosh, this is killing me. Does anyone else have this moment where they're like, I can draw hands, and then just like after a while, they're like, don't remember how to draw hands. Sorry, life, just don't remember. The flippity-jibbity is that. You know what, guys? It's just gonna have to do because I can't be bothered. Okay, fine. I'll redo the hand again. You win. I'll be happy. Okay, much better. Thank you. Jimmy's. Diamonds, darling. I don't really know if this is like showing diamonds, but we're trying. We're on to the final one. So here she is, if you know who she is, good job, because I think you guys, well, you'll see it before you need to comment, you know, so it doesn't really make sense to be like, try and guess. Try and guess. Why is this on there? I can't get it off. There we go. Oh no, it's like stuck. It's like melted into this. Oh, irritating. Ow. I'm all right. That was a bit lame. I'm okay. Don't worry, guys, I'm okay. She's also quite a tall lady. I've drawn her. That's fine. I really like this drawing I've done, so I don't need to go in and redo anything like I did with this one, so hopefully it will be fine. I really want to get all this stuff, but I know it's just not going to happen, so. Also, add like little like X shapes to indicate sparkles there, and I'm not sure if they shows, but hopefully it does. Okay, this dress is very red, but it's like a peachy red. That's not correct. I think I'll use R6. Just because if I use the darkest color, it's like there's no turning back. This dress is so cool though. This movie is a little unhinged. I think I saw this movie when I was like, probably like 10. It's a bit odd, isn't it? Like, even though it is like, they don't show anything. It's just a bit weird. Like, yes, she's a prostitute. You're like, okay. Oh, she falls in love. Oh, nice. It's the ultimate movie to be like, prostitutes are people too, okay? And you were like, yes. 10-year-old me, yes, I understand that. But it was a good movie, I guess, in that sense, if you think about it. Because I think back in the day, they weren't seen as people. And also, I think you call them sex workers now. So there's another mistake I made. Cute. Okay, what else? Hair. Ginger. I can't believe this is the last one. This is absolutely crazy. Drawing these for like what feels like forever, but it hasn't actually been that long, but it feels like forever. Oh, I think I'm not gonna do the necklace because from the reference image, it's like when she's first coming out of the room. She's like, look at my dress, I'm beautiful. Shadows. And you guys are probably thinking, hey Steph, there's loads of footage left, time left on this video. That's because I filmed myself doing the other ones, but I didn't talk whilst I did it, so I was just like, maybe I'll use this footage, maybe I won't. So now what's gonna play is the footage of drawing all of these. So if you fancy sticking around and watching that in just like silence, or maybe having it on in the background as you draw, because like sometimes that helps people, you can. And I thought that would be nice. I don't know. It's, yeah, it's long, so enjoy that. I'm just literally putting the footage there so you guys can just watch it, don't watch it, and that's the end of it. That's it, to be quite honest. You don't have to. It would be helpful if you did. Well, yeah, it would be helpful. I was like, why would it be helpful? And then I was like, no, it would be. For my channel, my little small baby channel that I have. Ooh, her hand is massive. Why did I do that? More the line than the actual... more the line that I did. That was just too big. Oh, this feels so nice to be the last one. Although, I already started on another one because I was like, I really enjoyed doing this even though it's painstaking. But I was thinking of doing the Taylor Swift Eras tour because I'm outing myself now, but I am a massive Swiftie. And yeah, it will be fun to do all her different costume changes from the Eras tour. And I thought that would be cool because I'm gonna go see it, the Eras tour as well in London. When am I going? August? Let me know, guys, if anyone's around. Yeah, if anyone's going, let me know. I'll be like, yeah, I'm going as well. I mean, most of my audience, I think, is in America, so it'd be very weird, not weird, but rare if you were going, if you happen to watch this video to the end of this, and then you were going on top of that, then it's very rare. But that would be cool. Okay, I need to shut up about Taylor Swift. It's like an obsession at this point. Right, we're nearly done. This is like the final lines of this drawing. I can't believe it. I think I do need to do some, what is up with her mouth? Why is it like, oh, I need to get another one of those smaller rubbers because this just doesn't work. It rubs out everything. Not just the small lines that I want to do. Yes, yes. And then maybe just shadows and some cheeks. Oh my god. Okay, her whole face is bright red, whatever. I don't know why I just did that. That is ultimate, like, last final stance on this drawing. If it looks terrible, I can fix it in Photoshop, but maybe it's quite cute because she's a bit shy. She's like, I'm wearing this dress, I'm embarrassed because I look good. All right, that's it. That's the final one. I literally cannot believe that I've finally finished this. It's done, hooray. Okay, so I'm probably gonna scan it in and then clean it up in Photoshop and maybe make a poster of it or make some stickers, maybe? I don't know, it was fun to do. Let me know what you guys think. Please leave a like and a comment and all that stuff. But also I said, what you can see now, if you wanna continue drawing along with me, is that the footage of me doing all of these up now, without me talking, without me waffling on. Is that good for you? Okay. Right, see you there then, and bye for now.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.